It begins, huh?
Pop, Mike Monroe from The Athletic.
Mikey, hi. Haven't seen you in a while.
Not in a while.
Have you been out in Hawaii with Nelly doing that thing?
but Pop,
it's sinking in though, right?
How do you honor the opportunity that the organization has now gotten to get a player with such amazing skills, but also a human being who seems to have amazing values?
Well, certainly there is enough that's happened in this organization that makes one wonder why we've been the recipients of so much serendipity, for sure. And of course, there's no answer to that, but I would just relate to you that we've mentioned many times in the past couple of decades and a half, I guess, when things weren't going well and somebody would show some sympathy or empathy, and we would just laugh and say, why? Why do we deserve that? With the draft picks that we've been able to have, any adversity that comes our way probably equals the equation a little bit. So with every situation like this with Victor, you have to stop and think about the fact that in the down times, you didn't feel sorry for yourself. In this life, there are ups and downs, and as you've often heard, it's trite, but to not take yourself too seriously with the good stuff and the bad stuff. Just carry on, do your job, and hope for the best. So we're thrilled that we're able to bring Victor on board. He's obviously a heck of a talent, a very mature young man, but just like with every draft pick, whether it's the first pick or the 27th pick or the 38th pick, we have a responsibility, each and every one, to try to create an environment where they can reach the best success possible for them.
Hello, Coach.
Hi.
Jazz Hornier with Air Alamo. My question is, what would be your advice to Wemby on how to handle the amount of pressure and expectation that has been put on him?
Well, I'll know what I'm going to say to him when I get to know him a little bit better. We don't have a personal relationship yet. But from what I've seen, I don't think he's going to need a lot from me in handling pressure. His parents have already done a hell of a job.
Can you all raise your hands if you have a question? Sarah?
Hi, Sarah DeMano with the Financial Times. I'm just wondering if you can talk a little bit about the attitude of the organization and the atmosphere in San Antonio between lottery night and tonight, and what, if any, preparations you've done spiritually or from a basketball perspective to get through today.
I'm not sure I understand your question, but there's a lot of difference between spirituality and basketball.
I mean, from both ends. Like, I guess there was a foregone conclusion that, you know, with the Spurs taking the first pick, that it would be Wemby. There have been murals going up around town. Just how has that interregnum period been in the city of San Antonio and within the organization?
I guess that I can't speak for the city. I know how excited they are and how excited they were when we ended up with the first pick. But the city has always had a love affair with the Spurs, so it doesn't change no matter who we pick or what year it is. They've always been loyal, faithful fans who enjoy the Spurs, and the players in return have always understood their responsibility to the city. So we didn't do anything different in preparation. You know, we are who we are, and the city has always supported us. So we didn't take any extra steps to make this a whole lot different.
Coach Michael Wright, NBA.com. I kind of want to follow up on Jazz's question here. When she talked about expectations, he's got sky-high expectations for himself. The team has its own expectations. And I'm curious how you go about sort of combining and marrying all that up to achieve the best outcome possible for both parties.
Yeah, that's a great question, because it is about expectations. It's about not skipping steps, which I say often. It's, you know, A to B to C to D in a variety of levels. You know, one is O's and X's in the game. The rules are a little bit different, obviously, than FIBA. You'll have to get used to that. Because of all the hype, he'll have a target on his back. So more than O's and X's to begin with, we'll be most interested in setting a framework and an environment where he's comfortable, where he can be Victor. He's not LeBron or Tim or Kobe or anybody else. He's Victor, and that's who we want him to be. So we'll do what we've done in the past with every player. We'll observe. We'll be there to counsel, to suggest, to answer questions. Be available as they matriculate into a team, into a city, into a home, you know, where they're going to eat their meals, who's going to make their meals. Every facet of an existence, just like each of us has an existence, will be very observant. But there's nothing in stone where we're going to already say, this is the way it's going to be. People asked with Tim Duncan, What do you think he needs? What are you going to do? I said, I have no idea. We're going to get him on the court, and we're going to see him play. And we'll go from there. But as far as being overly, you know, helicopter-like, that's not a good way to start.
Coach Alex Sabario, KRGV. Over the last month, the organization couldn't speak publicly that they were going to draft Wemby. The media's all talked about it, and everyone in the basketball world has talked about it, but the Spurs can't talk about it until now. How would you assess, from a coaching perspective, Wemby's game, how he fits into the pantheon of the Spurs that you've coached over the years, and just how excited you are to coach him?
I don't compare players, so that'll never happen. As I just said, he's Victor, and that's who I want him to be, and that's who myself and our staff will coach. And, of course, anybody would be excited about getting the number one pick in a draft, so I'm very excited. You don't want me to jump up and down, do you?
No.
Put on a show for you?
I'd
do a somersault, but I'd be out for 3 months.
Matthew Tynan with Corporate Knowledge. You talked about framework. You talked about support.
Did you steal that from us?
Yes, absolutely.
Thank you.
Yeah. I thought it made sense around here.
Wow.
Yeah.
What's your question?
My question is, you talked about the framework. You talked about the support system.
Did you do Pound the Rock, too?
I did. I literally wrote for him, too. I'm not responsible.
Did you write
the
poem?
I'm not Jacob Reese.
Jacob would be very angry with you. Go ahead.
You talked about the framework, the support system. The guys that are already in the building, how do you assess the way they performed last year? How do you assess what they look like going forward as you try to put this team around Victor?
The guys that played for us last year and they're continuing have had a great summer. And I mean that with all my heart, a great summer. The the coaches and the development people have been in charge of all that. I haven't done a damn thing except observe here and there. All of the players individually with skills, understanding how we want to play and how we have to play in this league as they get older and develop has been great. So we're very excited to put them with Victor, to say the least.
Andrew Lopez, ESPN.com, kind of building off of Mike's question earlier about the expectations. How have you, even from afar, been maybe impressed with how he has so far handled everything up until this point?
You know, he's got a great disposition. You know, a good combination of an intellectual ability and an emotional intelligence at the same time. He understands what hype is. He understands all the attention he's getting. But he still welcomes it and deals with it. You know, when he came out of the airport in New York City, came out and he signed autographs, he smiled with everybody. He kind of enjoyed the moment, that sort of thing. After 15 or 18 years, he might not enjoy it as much. But right now, he's been very accessible to everybody, and he's enjoying it. So I think he understands that there's a way to handle that responsibility and still let people feel, you know, somewhat close to him. So he doesn't need a lot of advice in that area.
Coach Hector Ledesma with Sports Tonight. Do you see Victor playing in the summer league?
We're talking about what he should be doing moving forward. You know, he never stopped playing. He went right into the playoffs in the French league, and you know that just ended. But he will participate in the summer league. To what degree, we're not exactly sure yet. As I said before, I've only spoken with him on the phone a couple of times, so I got to get a better feel for where his head is at. Talk to his people who have trained him his whole life. You know, they've been with our people, and we've got to make those decisions once we're all together. But he'll be there at some point.
We've got two more guys.
Raul. Coach Raul, the Mickey's Associated Press. You talked a little bit about last season. Last season was obviously a tough one, but it seemed like the players really gave their all and didn't give up. How does that, what they did last season, how does that sort of carry over into this year?
Well, you know, whether you win a championship or you have a one-loss record that's not enviable like we did last year, players are resilient. They want to improve. They want to move on. They want to develop. So the one-loss actually is pretty irrelevant. You know, we enjoyed the season because we had such great guys character-wise that it didn't matter how many we lost in a row. What mattered was the film session the next day and what we have to do. And they'd be at practice or the next game and try to fulfill everything we wanted them to do. So in a sense, it was one of the most, and this will sound strange, more enjoyable years. It was fun in a way, not being on TV much, you know, and you just go to work and you don't worry about results other than players developing and a team understanding going forward. And they were A-plus in all those regards, and they stuck together where a lot of teams that are in that situation really implode. So I was really proud of them, respected the hell out of them for being able to have that kind of mental toughness. And that's what they'll carry forward into this season.
Thank you. Weston Cornet from France 24. I have a couple questions. You know Tony Parker really well. Tony Parker has watched Victor Wembanyama play many, many times. Have you and Tony spoken about him, and what has he told you?
Sure, I've spoken with Tony and, you know, a lot of people, as you might expect. Tony's a big fan.
I'm available for
I'm sorry?
That's the second question. Have you decided whether you'd make him available for France for the World Championships?
That's a decision that I don't think has been made yet.
Thank you, guys.
Whoa.
Will Timmy, work with him a little bit more than he has with other players in the past?
Well, I don't know what level you think Timmy's worked with other players, so I can't compare that. But Timmy's in the gym a lot. Mono's in the gym a lot. Fab's in the gym when he can be here. You know, former players, Sean, Tony, these guys, when they're here, they come in. But as far as developing on a day-to-day basis, you know, that Timmy won't be doing that. But you can guarantee that they'll have conversations. Victor's already expressed interest in, you know, spending time with Timmy, with David, that kind of thing. So that'll happen. You just won't see him drilling them out here on the court.
Greg, one more. This will be the last one.
Who says?
It's me again.
Oh, who says? What are you?
You can answer as many questions as you want.
Jeez, a whiz.
You once said you had to allow Manu to be Manu. Victor plays the game a little differently than most big men. Are you anticipating there may be a time where you have to say, I have to let Victor be Victor?
Sure. I think I already said that. I'm going to watch him. I'm going to see what happens. And you were right about Manu. Oh, he was a pain in the ass. I say that because he's right over there in the other room. You know, I learned so much from Manu about that very thing. You can't make players into what you think they should be. You really have to understand what they have and how to capitalize on that, because no player is perfect. And learning how to zip it once in a while will serve me well as I watch Victor or Calden or Devin. It doesn't matter who it is. We all hopefully learn as we grow and get a little bit older. Anybody else? All right. Take care.
Thank you, Kevin.
Good to see you.
Thanks for coffee.
You bet.